learning about the brain is important because it's learning about ourselves.
What goes on when we put things in our memory, when we make decisions, when we have emotions and so on? Understanding our brain is going to allow us to understand what makes us human.
Let me ask the question, what other organ allows us to ask how it works?
How is it that an intelligence can understand its own structure and comprehend how it functions?
It's the greatest problem of all because it is our brain, our mind, we use to understand everything else.
This mush of goo that's our brain, it gives rise to this incredible creativity and feats that the humankind has accomplished.
So to understand humanity, you have to understand the brain.
At the McGovern Institute, everyone got into this field because they believe that fundamental knowledge about the brain is ultimately going to help a lot of people.
Brain diseases affect over 1 billion people around the world. Alzheimer's, addiction, Parkinson's disease, epilepsy, the list goes on and on.
By working together and understanding how the brain works, we can develop new treatments, new interventions that make people's lives better.
When Pat and Lori McGovern founded the McGovern Institute, they wanted us to be the place where people came to do neuroscience.
So this is 2000. This is 25 years ago. MIT is exploding.
At the time, neuroscience at MIT was fragmented in various buildings, various places, various departments.
And we needed to find ways of integrating molecular biology with neuroscience up through cognitive neuroscience.
And here is this new institute beginning to form what is the center of neuroscience at MIT.
What might this institute actually become? We were aiming very, very high.
I think we wanted to dream really big in terms of what we could achieve with the best people in the best institution with the best outcome.
And my dream is that when the history book of the 21st century is written, they will say the quality of life for all people was improved because we really got to understand the function of the brain. And by the way, the McGovern Institute played a measurable and significant role in making that happen.
Brain science is omnidisciplinary. We need every science to help us.
Besides neuroscientists, we have engineers, we have material scientists, chemists, physicists, mathematicians, and computer scientists, and they're all under the same roof.
Most of the big questions in neuroscience right now require multiple methods spanning levels.
You need to get to the fundamental mechanisms, right? Molecules, cells, and the building blocks of the brain. And then how do we understand how those add up to generate things like cognition or consciousness?
And it's really by looking at this entire spectrum from small to large that we can start to understand what are the basic mechanisms that underlie disease. And then we can develop new treatments based on that understanding.
To do this requires development of new tools and deployment of those tools in meaningful ways.
Of course, there are many technologies developed here. CRISPR technology is one of the key things.
The CRISPR system, which bacteria uses to fight off viruses, can be harnessed to turn into gene editing tools to be able to treat genetic disease and also advancing brain research.
Then you need to be able to see how the brain is changing at the nanomolecular level. And there we have the new tool, expansion microscopy.
With expansion microscopy, we can take a piece of brain tissue and make it 1,000 times bigger to make maps of the brain down to molecular scale.
Once you bring all of these neurons together, we build mathematical models, we build computer simulations to try to understand what kind of function and dynamics they're going to have.
It's this constant cycle of developing new tools, collecting better data, and then building better models to explain how this is all working. The most important factor in science is the people that you work with.
The collection of faculty is very diverse, from neurotechnology to molecular to systems to computational. You can get help, get knowledge, or get a collaboration next door.
Every single faculty is the leader of their subfield. That is very rare.
So pretty much anything I need to know, there's somebody right there who's the world expert who can tell me about it.
The staff of the McGovern Institute is unbelievably supportive.
we're just incredibly privileged to have people who help us carry the science to the world in the best ways.
The students and the postdocs are just stellar and beyond compare.
They're the future of neuroscience.
It's a community full of seekers, working on important things, important problems.
McGovern is at the cutting edge in terms of research, but at the same time, it's extremely friendly.
It's full of incredible scientists who are also incredibly kind, and so you're able to take risks with your science.
We have an opportunity to do a kind of science that a lot of people in the world just can't do and answer the kind of questions that they can't answer.
We, in doing so, are able to provide so much hope to so many people, and that wouldn't be possible without the opportunities we get here.
The most important thing is just that researchers continue to follow their passion.
Every day we learn something new, constantly working and producing these really exciting discoveries.
That's why McGovern is so magical.
The McGovern has made incredible progress. There's all sorts of science that's been learned. We're doing things that were unimaginable.
There are almost night and day improvements in how we can study the brain.
See, we're a very exciting moment in the field of all kinds of breakthroughs that can make a big difference in people's lives.
McGovern Institute is defined by its people. These are people who want to work together, who believe in this mission, and pursue the most innovative, newest ideas in understanding the brain at all levels.